We have completed the all joint structures and ligamentous structures of the foot, right? So we'll discuss the soft tissue of the foot. As you already know and already learned about the flexor tendon sheaths, extensor hoods of the toes, right? And plantar aponeurosis. Okay, we already discussed all about all of them in some detail. We'll learn about them in great detail. Coming to the retinacula. Okay, retinacula is fascia. Okay, thickened fascia. Okay, in the vicinity of the ankle joint, the tendons of the muscles of the leg are bound. Localized band shape thickenings of the deep fascia, right? Termed retinacula, which collectively serve to prevent bowstringing of the underlying tendon during muscle contraction. Okay, so in order to prevent this bowstringing, right? Retinacula are there to preserve the structure, right? So these are the retinacula, extensor retinacula, which is superior and inferior, and flexor retinacula and fibular retinacula, which is superior and inferior again. Okay. So superior extensor retinacula. Superior extensor retinacula binds down the tendons of, you have to remember these things. So once you know the location, okay, you know all the anatomical structures present there, right? Tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, right? Extensor digitorum longus, fibularis tertius, right? So all of these pass dorsal aspect of foot, right? Immediately proximal to the anterior aspect of the ankle joint, right? Okay. You see, this is the superior, you see, superior extensor retinacula, a thickened deep fascia, thickened deep fascia, right? The whole, this is the superior extensor retinacula. So all the tendons of the muscles of the leg which goes to the foot are bound by this. Okay, this is the tibialis anterior and extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus. Okay, right? Okay, this structure prevents the bowstringing, right? This structure prevents the bowstringing, and the anterior tibial vessels and deep fibular nerve pass deep to the retinaculum, right? You see, anterior tibial vessels, this is anterior lateral malleolar artery, medial malleolar artery. Okay, this is anterior tibial artery, right? Anterior tibial artery. All of these passes deep to the extensor retinaculum, whereas the superficial fibular nerve, right? You see here, this is deep fibular nerve. Deep fibular nerve passes deep to the extensor retina, you know, whereas the superficial fibula nerve passes superficially, okay, superficial to the extensor retina. You see, this is superficial fibula nerve is superficial to the extensor retina, right? The retinaculum is attached laterally to the distal end of the anterior border of the fibula, okay, laterally to the fibula and medially to the anterior border of the tibia, right? Its proximal border is continued with the deep fascia of the leg, okay, and dense connective tissue connects its distal border to the inferior extensor retinaculum. It is continuous with the above with the leg and below with the inferior extensor retinaculum. Laterally, it blends with the superior fibular retinaculum, right? Superior fibular retinaculum. Medially with the upper border of the extensor retinaculum. You see, this is the tibia, right? This is fibula. So lower border of the tibia, lower border of the fibula, right? Below it is continuous as the inferior extensor retinaculum, right? You see, these are the tendinous sheaths. Observe them closely, all the tendons. You see here, below it is continuous as inferior extensor retinaculum. Laterally it bounds with the fibular retinaculum. I'll show that in a minute. Okay. This is the extent of superior extensor retinaculum. See this one. And laterally it continues as the most of the time it blends with the fibular retinaculum. Right? Fibular retinaculum. Coming to the inferior extensor retinaculum. The inferior extensor retinaculum is a Y-shaped band lying anterior to the ankle joint. The stem of the Y is at the lateral end where it is attached to the upper surface of the calcaneus anterior to the calcaneal sulcus. Right? So, the stem means this part. This one is attached to the calcaneum. Right? The band passes medially forming a strong loop around the tendons of the fibularis tertius and extensor digitorum longus, right? You see, this is the cadaveric specimen, superior extensor retinaculum, whereas this one is inferior extensor retinaculum. You see, this is the band they are talking about, okay? Y-shaped band. This one is attached to the calcaneum. Right, calcaneum. See, so you see, these are this is extensor digitorum brevis, right? See, inferior extensor retinaculum, and these are the loops, right? Fibularis tertius, this one is, and this is extensor digitorum longus and extensor digitorum brevis, okay? All of these structures passes beneath inferior extensor retinaculum, right? Okay, you see, this is more clear, okay, including dorsalis pedis artery, all of this. Okay. inferior extensor written aakilam, right? The band is attached to the tibia, and here it attached like this. Okay, these are the loops, right? Calcaneal sulcus. Superior is continuous as continuous with superior extensor retinaculum. From the deep surface of the loop, a band passes laterally behind the intraosseous talocalcaneal ligament and cervical ligament and is attached to the calcaneal sulcus. Right? At the medial end of the loop, two diverging limbs extend medially to the complete Y shape of the retinaculum. The proximal limb consists of two layers. The deep layer passes deep to the tendon of extensor hallucis longus and tibialis anterior, but superficial to the anterior tibial vessels and deep fibular nerve to reach the medial malleolus. So a deep layer passes beneath the tendons of extensor hallucis longus and tibialis anterior, but it is superficial to the that means the tibial vessels and deep fibular nerve are deep to the deep layer of the inferior extensor retinaculum, and superficial layer crosses superficial to the tendon of extensor hallucis longus. There he adheres firmly to the deep one. That means extensor hallucis longus, EHL, and tibialis anterior are sandwiched between superficial and deep layers of inferior extensor retinaculum, right? You understand the point? Between the superficial layer and deep layer of the inferior extensor retinaculum, loop of the inferior extensor retinaculum, lies the tendon of the extensor hallucis longus and tibialis anterior, right? That is about the proximal limb. Okay, that means I'll show you. You see, this is the proximal. This is the proximal limb, right? This one is proximal limb, and this one is distal limb, right? And the distal limb extends downwards and medially and blends with the plantar aponeurosis. You see, the plantar aponeurosis is also the fascia, right? So it is superficial to the tendons of, again, the distal limb is superficial to the tendons of extensor hallucis longus and tibialis anterior, the dorsalis pedis artery, and the terminal branches of the deep fibular nerve. So all these tendons and vessels are lies beneath the distal limb of inferior extensor retinaculum, right? You see, this is fibular retinaculum. You see, this is the proximal limb, distal limb. This one is proximal limb. Okay, you see, this is the extensor hallucis longus, right? Right. Inferior extensor retinaculum. This is the distal limb. This is the proximal limb, right? And you see, the proximal limb has, this is the superficial one, and this is the deep one, right? You observe that? So between the superficial and deep are sandwiched the tendons of the extensor hallucis longus, right? And tibialis anterior. You see, this is the tibialis anterior and this is EHL, right? Between these two, that means, and okay, so red one is superficial and yellow one is deep, right? Again, those two tendons are covered by distal loop of inferior extensor retinaculum, right? I hope you got the point clearly, right? Coming to the flexor retinaculum, right? Flexor retinaculum is attached anteriorly to the medial malleolus, anteriorly to the medial malleolus, distal to which it is continuous with the deep fascia on the dorsum of the foot. Right? From its malleolar attachment, it extends posterior inferiorly to the medial process of the calcaneus and the plantar aponeurosis. So, from medial malleolus to the calcaneum and almost to the plantar aponeurosis. Right? Proximally, there is no demarcation between its border and the deep fascia of the leg. That means, proximally, it is continuous with the deep fascia of the leg. Okay? And especially deep transverse layer of the deep fascia. Distally, its border is continuous with the plantar aponeurosis. That means, above, it is continuous with the deep fascia of the leg. Below, it is continuous with the plantar aponeurosis. Which one? Flexor retinaculum. Okay? And many fibers of adductor hallucis are attached to it. The flexor retinaculum converts a groove on the tibia and calcaneus into canals for tendons, right? And bridges over the posterior tibial vessels and tibial nerve. Okay, remember this. This is a very important point. As these structures enter the sole, they are from medial to lateral. The tendons of the tibial is posterior from medial to lateral. Right? Flexor digitorum longus and posterior tibial vessels and tibial nerve and tendon of flexor hallucis longus, right? From medial to lateral or tibialis anterior, flexor digitorum longus and flexor hallucis longus tendons, right? So these structures pass through a canal which is called as tarsal tunnel, okay? Tarsal tunnel, right, which is formed by the posterior medial side of the ankle in the talus, medial malleolus. You see, a depression formed by the medial malleolus of the tibia, medial and posterior surface of the talus, okay? That is like this. And medial surface of the calcaneus, okay? Medial malleolus, talus and calcaneus and the inferior surface of the sustentaculum talus, right? Inferior surface of sustentaculum talus and the overlying flexor retinaculum. So, all of these are formed as a groove because of the flexor retinaculum. You see, here it is, okay? So, this is called as tarsal tunnel. As the vessels pass through these tunnel, okay? Vessels and neurovascular structures, right? So, whenever they are inflamed, there will be pain in this region which extends to the like this manner, okay? That is called as tarsal tunnel syndrome, okay? TTS. That is why this structure is important. See, the retinaculum is continuous above with the deep fascia of the leg, okay, and below with the deep fascia of the foot, plantar aponeurosis. Septa from the flexor retinaculum converts the groove on the bones into the tubular connective tissue channels for the tendons of the flexor muscles as they pass into the sole of the foot from the posterior compartment of the leg. Right, free movement of the tendons in these channels is facilitated by synovial sheaths which surround the tendons. Two compartments on the posterior surface of the medial malleolus for the tendons of tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus. The tendon of the tibialis posterior is medial to the tendon of the flexor digitorum longus. Okay, immediately lateral to the tendon of tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus, posterior tibial artery with it associated with veins and tibial nerve. Okay, pass through tarsal tunnel into the sole of the foot. The pulse of the posterior tibial artery. Okay, these are the important things. Felt through the flexor retinaculum midway between the medial malleolus and the calcaneus. Okay. Lateral to the tibial nerve is the compartment on the posterior surface of the talus and under surface of sustained tibialis talus for the tendon of FHL. Right. You see, observe this closely. Tibial is posterior, right? FDL and FHL. Right. This one is FHL. Most medial one is tibialis posterior. Next to that, lateral to the tibialis posterior is flexor digitorum longus. After then, artery, vein, and nerve. Right? In this fashion. Artery, vein, and nerve. And after that, most lateral part is FHL. Right? You see? This is the flexor retinaculum. Right? Which prevents the bowstringing of the tendons of tibialis posterior and extensor digitorum longus and flexor digitorum longus and flexor hallucis longus, right? See, this is the flexor retinaculum. So all of these behind the medial malleolus, right? Pass behind the medial malleolus. You all know that. X. Tibialis posterior, EHL, FHL, and FDL and FHL. See, this is the flexor retinaculum, right? Red one. Here it is more clear. Flexor retinaculum. Underlies this is the tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, and this one is the tendon. Neurovascular structure, right? Again, this is now more clear as we have, again it has superficial and deep part, okay? Flexor retinaculum, superficial part and deep part, right? This is the superficial part, this is the deep part. This is the flexor retinaculum, right? Observe that. Coming to the last one in the retinaculum, fibular retinaculum. Fibular retinaculum of fibrous bands that retain the tendons of fibularis longus and fibularis brevis. Only these two tendons in position as the tendons cross the lateral aspect of the ankle region. Okay, again, these are superior and inferior. Superior fibular retinaculum is short band that extends from the back of the lateral malleolus to the deep transverse fascia of the leg and the lateral surface of the calcaneus. So lateral malleolus to the lateral surface of calcaneus. Damage to the retinaculum can lead to the instability of tendons of fibularis longus and brevis. Coming to the inferior fibular. Inferior is continuous in front with the inferior extensor retinaculum. Okay, extension of inferior extensor retinaculum, inferior fibular retinaculum is and is attached posteriorly to the lateral surface of the calcaneus. Summit surface fused with the periosteum of the fibular trochlea or peroneal trochlea. Calcaneus forming a septum between the tendons of fibularis longus and brevis. You see, these are the two tendons, okay, fibularis longus and brevis, right? This is longus. This one is brevis. this is the superior and this is the inferior fibula retinacula, right? You see, this one is superior fibula retinacula, this one is inferior. So this is superior fibula retinacula, inferior fibula retinacula. As I said earlier, once you know the location, it is more easier to remember the structures around it. Okay, see, this one is inferior, this one is superior fibula retinacula. See, superiorly, okay, and inferiorly covering the tendons of the fibularis longus and brevis, right? So with that, we end the retinaculum. Coming to the 3D anatomy. Okay. You see, that is the superior extensor retinaculum, right? That is between tibia and fibula, right? You see, those are the structures, all the tendons pass beneath the superior extensor retinaculum. That one is tibialis anterior, and that muscle extensor hallucis longus, and this one is extensor digitorum longus, and this one is peroneus tertius. Okay, you see, peroneus tertius is the extensor retinaculum, whereas peroneus longus and brevis are covered by fibular retinaculum, right? These are the brevis, fibularis brevis, and this is the fibularis longus, right? Peroneus longus. So those are covered by, you see, this is the inferior fibular retinaculum, and this is the superior fibular retinaculum, right? I think you got my point. Okay, so these two structures, these two retinacula, fibular retinacula, covers the peroneus longus and peroneus brevis, whereas the peroneus tertius, okay, along with digitorum longus and digitorum brevis and extensor hallucis longus and tibialis anterior are covered by extensor retinaculum. This is superior extensor retinaculum, this is inferior extensor retinaculum. You see the Y band, okay, here it is, and it is continuous as the inferior fibular retinaculum, right? You see, so here these bands, right, proximal and distal one. Proximal covers tibialis anterior and flexor hallucis longus, right? All of these things. And here goes the flexor retinaculum, right? It is the flexor retinaculum which covers the tendons of, this is tibialis posterior, this is flexor digitorum longus, and this is this tendon, most lateral one is FHL, flexor hallucis longus, right? These are the arterial structure. You see, the dorsalis pedis artery, and this one is tibia antitibial artery. Okay, arterial structures, and the venous structures passing behind tibial veins. Okay. You see, this is the neurovascular structures passing behind flexor retinaculum. You see, posterior tibial veins, arteries, and tibial veins plant, which becomes middle and lateral plantar artery and vein. You see, these are the tarsal tunnel structures, right? Plantar now, tibial now. Right. So this is how if you hide this, okay, this is how it will be like this, but that is flexor retina too. So this is how the retinaculum, these are the retinaculum, right? Okay, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you have any doubts, let me know.